Before the lights, before the cameras, and before the MLB, Indians pitcher Ryan Merritt stood right here on this mound. Rookies Ezekiel Elliott and Dak Prescott have done it once again, this time against one of the best defensive lines in the NFL. The Ryan Raiders came into this game ranked third best in Class 5A football. Right now, the Cowboys are undefeated on the road and just need two more games to get that record. The LA Kings are coming to the American Airlines Center full of desperation as they start the season off 0-3. The Packers have given up less than 45 yards a game on the ground, while the Cowboys have put up over 150. After being away from the game for about a year and a half, Kenny Hill went in the game and threw two early interceptions. The Dallas Cowboys' $70 million man, Dez Bryant, missed an MRI Monday and Tuesday. He was nervous about the results that he was going to receive. The rivalry between the Dallas Cowboys and Washington Redskins has been renewed. After the Packers game, Washington fans were yelling, "We want Dallas! We want Dallas!" The Texas Rangers are that much closer to a second straight AL West title. The Dallas Cowboys are dealing with a handful of injuries, including one to their $70 million man. But for how long will he be sidelined? That's coming up after the break. I'm outside of the Oak Street Draft House, where several people will be lined up for a free 5K later tonight. Right now, I'm with the guy who organized the whole thing, Tony Roman. Thanks for joining us. And what was the idea behind this whole thing? After he retired, he was then named to the North Texas Hall of Fame, class of 1988. Dole Christman passed away at the age of 97 years old, leaving great memories for his family, friends, and fellow UNT comrades. Safety Keyshawn McClain was awarded Defensive Player of the Week, while freshman wideout Tyler Wilson was named Special Teams Player of the Week. Players like Tyrone Smith, Lyle Collins, and Doug Free are being evaluated each day. If you would have told me at the beginning of the season a Dallas Cowboys defender would have won Player of the Week award, I would have probably questioned you a little bit. The Rockets are scoring 125 points a game, which is best in the NBA, but they also give up the most points in the league. As if the elections weren't giving you enough stress, the World Series has come down to the final game. The Cubs were down 3-1, but tied it up heading into the final matchup. Each week, I talk about professional and college sports, but what about people like me and you? Well, I'll have a cool way that you can get a free workout while having a great time. Stick around. North Texas was struggling to score in the first half, and in the second, it only got worse. 7 total, 5 down, and 2 to go. The Mavericks are playing in their second-to-last preseason game and their last home game before the season starts. It'll be interesting now to see how Dak Prescott plays, considering he's never had a guy like Tony Romo waiting on the bench to go in behind him. This game was at a stalemate for a while, then went into overtime, where Dallas has not performed well all season. And those struggles continued as the Devils winger Adam Henrick puts this one away. Senior forward Rachel Holden and senior midfielder Marshall Davis were named to the Conference USA All-Second Team. Bryant finished the game, and he's lucky he didn't get hurt because doctors say that he has a hairline fracture in that left knee. The Dallas Stars even out their road record to 1-1 after taking down the Predators in a 2-1 nail-biter. Lynch finished in first place this past weekend, leading the women's team to its first Ken Garland Invitational title in 6 years. Last night, bases were loaded, and Cubs shortstop Addison Russell hit a grand slam to extend their lead to 7. Indians fans around the ballpark were just in disbelief. Well, my hat's off to her because I cannot even tell you the last time I went running, but that's all I have for sports. Back to you, Shelby.
When starting quarterback Tony Romo went down in a preseason game against Seattle, many thought the year was over once again, but nobody saw this coming.
An empty gun, Dak back looking, now sprints out right, now throws it over the middle, Beasley at the 12, at the 5, touchdown!
And line one with Dak Prescott up to this point is just his poise and composure to handle any situation.
With the fourth round pick out of Mississippi State in Dak Prescott, along with fellow rookie Ezekiel Elliott, the two have so far saved the day. Without Romo, Dallas is 5-1, even winning 3 of those games without star receiver Dez Bryant.
You know, I'm excited, I get to be back with my teammates. You know, get to be part of excitement. It's just fun, you know, just can't wait to get out there and have fun.
With the timetable for Romo's return unknown, some fans have mixed emotions on who should be the starter once Romo's healthy.
You play the guys who give you the best chance to win, and if you're winning, like I said, you kind of stick with the hot hand.
In my opinion, for what it's worth, this is Tony's team. He hadn't done anything to lose the job.
But from the beginning, Dak has said the same thing when asked about the quarterback dispute.
It's Tony's team. I think I knew that going into the situation. I think everybody knew that. I'm just trying to do the best I can to give my team a chance to win week in and week out.
Dak is doing such a good job that there's a quarterback dispute, debate, conversation, whatever you want to call it. But the people in this building right behind me have a big decision to make in the weeks to come. Dak or Romo? Romo or Dak? That's the $1 million question. At Cowboys headquarters, I'm Brent Wise, CBS 11 Sports.